Hey guys, this is Ravi Sagar. Welcome to /now.in. In this video, I'll show you how to install WAMP server on Windows and how to configure document root. For starting your Drupal learning process, the first thing you need to do is set up a development environment on your machine. For that, you need to install PHP, MySQL, and Apache. But configuring these tools is not an easy task. If you're able to make it work correctly, then consider yourself lucky. If not, do not worry at all. WAMP server is an amazing tool that has PHP, MySQL, and Apache server pre-configured. All you need to do is go to wampserver.com and download the latest release and install it on your Windows machine just like any other application. I have already downloaded it on my desktop. Let me install it now, and I recommend it to install it at /wamp folder. So let me begin the installation process. I'll double click on the executable file. I'll run it. Okay, next. I accept the agreement. Next. Okay, so I'm installing my WAMP server at /wamp. Okay, so very easy thing, just like any other Windows application, I can simply run this file and my WAMP server will be ready within few minutes. I'll forward this video to the point where this installation is complete. Okay, so my WAMP server is now installed and it is now asking me for some configurations. So the first one is for the SMTP server. I am leaving it by default local server, and now it says launch WAMP server now. I'll say finish. I'll click on yes. Okay, so now the WAMP server is running, and let me open the console. Here you can see when you click on the WAMP server icon in the toolbar, you will see this menu, and you have to put it online for running your WAMP server, and this will basically start your Apache, PHP, and MySQL services. So I'll click on it. So you can see within few minutes I've installed WAMP server, and no need to worry about complex configurations, and WAMP server is hassle free way to configure your machine. So to test whether my server is running or not, I'll open a new window in my browser and I'll try to open localhost. Okay, great. So now you can see that the WAMP server is running, and this is the default screen that you see when your server is running successfully. Now, another thing that I wanted to show you in this video is how to specify your own document root, which is the place where all your website files are stored. You can use the default document root directory, but that is deep inside the WAMP folders, and it is always better to have it separately. I recommend a directory like /websites. So let me create a new directory under my C drive. I'll create a new folder. I'll call it websites. So now I want all my files, all my web projects inside this directory. But we need to tell WAMP server about this new directory that we have just created. So for that, you need to go inside the WAMP folder. I'll go inside bin, then Apache, Apache version, and you can see a directory here called as conf. I'll go inside this directory and I can see that there is a file called as httpd.conf. This is basically the configuration file where we can change the default document root to our new directory. So I'll open this file in Notepad++, which is an amazing tool for editing your text files, and I'll search for document root. Okay, so now you can see that the default document root is c:\vam/www, but I want it to be c:\websites. This is one thing. Another thing that you have to do is scroll down in this file, and under this directory you also need to change the location. So I'll again type websites. So I'll save this file, and after making these changes I'll restart my VAM server. So I'll click on the VAM server icon in the toolbar, and I'll say restart all services. I'll wait for it to restart. Okay, so now the VAM server has restarted. Now you can see that the local host in the browser is now showing empty screen, and it says index of and some name last modified and blah blah blah. So this is because we don't really have anything inside our c:\websites directory. And let me show you. If I create a new directory here, I'll say website project 1, and now if I refresh this, and you can see that this new directory that we just created is now visible under this localhost index. So this folder c:\websites will be the place where you want to save all your website projects. I hope now you can install and configure VAM server on your Windows machine. This is Ravi Sagar from slashno.in. Thank you for watching this video. Bye.